again. In this tutorial, you learn how to create just the primitives, just a plain solid, which will be in this case will be box, and play a little bit with the box. It means that I'm going to make a filleting, and I'm going to join with other objects, and I'm going to trim my solid by curve or something else. So have a look. So let's start with creating box. Box is just here appearing the first comment, first icon. You can you can see the small triangle at the bottom. You can select more if you press a little bit longer your mouse. But I need that one. This is the one I need. So I'm just selecting, making the box. If you don't have a shading in your perspective, just right click on your perspective name and then change from wireframe to shaded. Alright, so let's extend our perspective view to full screen and then have a look. I want to make a fillet on this edge. So I need to go to solid tools comments, and then there is a comment called variable radius fillet. Yeah, this is variable because you can really make it different in different corners of your creation. So you'll see later. So I'll choose the comment, and then software asking me to select edge to fillet. But before you will do, you have to set the radius. It can be, for example, 5, and press enter, and then go to your edge to select. You select edge, and software now telling you what is the parameter of your fillet. You just need to press enter, which is also right mouse button when your comment is open. Then the program tells you what are the filleting at the certain edges. So that's what I told you. Variable. I can change it here, and I can change it here. I can change it just by drag and drop, or I can just change it by keyboard. Number, yeah, writing. But I just first do the plain normal filleting, which will be in both cases the same. So if you just do normal 5 with all profiles, they're gonna be like that. All right, let's do a different corner with different profiles. Okay, so let's select the tool, let's select the comment. If I've made the comment fillet before, I can do it again by pressing right button. So I don't have to go to the comment list. So I'm selecting the edge, and I need to press enter, and then I just press the small point, and then, for example, going to be 1 on the keyboard. See? So now, if I just confirm by pressing the right mouse button, it's going to be this kind of shape. Well, this is a bit tricky because you can play a little bit more with the fillet. So look, not that one. And then I can actually add a handle here in the middle and make it nice and smooth. Shape. So look, I'm adding right now in the middle here. You have to have middle on, middle snapping on, and then I need to change which one. I will select, for example, let's change that one for bigger or no, that one for smaller. So let's say it's gonna be 2, and if I will just press enter, it will go look like this. Quite nice and fun. It gives you really nice modeling tool. And when you doing advanced objects, it will really help you to create this kind of features. Right. Let's do the last corner and play a little bit more with this. So let's add handle. Enter, and then let's change that one for 2. You'll see how it's gonna look. Nice. Okay, so we have kind of weird shape right now. What can we do with this? We can actually copy and paste it. So look, just Ctrl C, Ctrl V, and then move it a little bit just by drag and drop. And we can move it also in front view, look, like this. Okay. And we've got something like this. And we can actually cut one of this object by second. Let's go to the same list, common list. And this is like a common list called Boolean. This is Boolean union, which will actually give you one object out of the two. So if I press it right now and select two objects, they become one, joined together. But I don't want to do it right now. I want to do difference, which is cutting, kind of cutting. So look, I'm going to select the first set of surfaces. I'm going to cut within this surface, press enter, by using that surface. So look, I've got some kind of weird shape. And now I can play a little bit more with that. So let's do the fillet. So remember, in this kind of situation, when you are too close to the previous fillet, you have to be careful to not make a too big size here, because otherwise the feature won't work. So I'm just make a 5, it's too big. I can change here by drag and drop to see how it looks. Let's stay with this, and then here too. All right. Okay, it's quite good. It's nice. And let's do it the same here. Okay, drag and drop. It's all right, and here too. This kind of weird snapping is appearing right now because I've got too many snappings on. I just can unselect few of them to not get disturbed by any snapping string. Okay, this is quite a nice shape. So at the end of all this process, I can make one radius of one in set all one in here. Something is wrong. If something like that happened, it means that the software cannot make us fillet somewhere. So I have to go back and change the fillet, for example, for .5. This will help. Yeah, now it's much better. And in the same here. Alright, so we can do something with it, but this is going to be here, it's going to be real trouble, because this is kind of advanced modeling of surfaces. So let's stay with this for now. I will describe more advanced comments in further parts of my tutorials. So thank you for watching, and watch my next tutorial. I will tell more about the modification. See you.